Hello and welcome to Jobs and Education. Do subscribe and share my videos. This is your Mahesh Dole. This video provides you some of the important problems on manometers. Manometers are very important devices. So what is the function of a manometer? It is generally measures the pressure of a gas that are close to or below atmospheric pressure, because atmospheric pressure is used as a gauge pressure. So that's why below atmospheric pressure or equal to or near to that atmospheric pressure is measured with the help of manometer. Let's see the first problem. A manometer tube is filled with two type of liquids. So here we can see two types of liquids. The density of liquid one is, rho one is 0.8 gram centimeter per minus 3, and the density of liquid 2 is rho 2, that is 1, and the height h1 is 10 centimeter, and what is the height 2. So we know that according to manometer problems, so left hand side pipe equals to right hand side pipe. That's why we have the formula rho 1 gh1 equals to rho 2 gh2. So density of liquid 1 is 0.8, density of liquid 2 is 1, and height, first height is 10 centimeters. We need second height. So that's why to calculate H2, we are taking this rho 1 gh1 equals to rho 2 gh2. So anyway, gg gets cancelled here and here. So rho 1 h1 equals to rho 2 h2. By substituting the values, h2 is not there. So h2, we will get the h2, that is 8 centimeter. That is nothing but second side height, this side height. So this is the way of solving the problems on manometers. So left side and right side, we need to equate left side and right side. So this is what the way of solving the problems on manometers. Look at the second question. In figure, an inverted differential manometer is connected to two pipes A and B which convey water. The fluid is manometer is oil of a specific gravity 0.8. For the manometer readings shown in the figure, find the pressure difference between A and B. The question asking that try to find out PA minus PB. So let's observe this figure. So this height is 30, this height is 20, this is 30. So this is oil. From here to here it is oil. Oil is there. So this is liquid. So specific gravity of oil given as 0.8. So we need to convert that into density, that is 0.8 into 1000, that is 800 kg per meter cube. Next, difference of oil in the two limbs. Difference of oil, how to find out? So this side 30 plus 20, total 50 is there. Minus this side is 30. So we need this difference. To get this difference, we need to subtract this 30 from 50. So we'll get 50 minus 30 as 20 centimeters. So this equals to 20 centimeters. Taking datum line at xs, this is xx datum line. Pressure in the left limb below xx is, left side pressure is PA minus 1000 into 9.81 into, this is, look at it, rho g h. What is height here? 30. So h is 30, this is not 0, 30. So this is 30. So 1000 into 9.81 into h is 30, that will get as PA minus 2943. Let's take it as first equation. Pressure in the left limb below xx, that is PB minus pressure in the right limb, this is not left limb, right limb, PB minus rho g h1, rho 1 g h1 minus rho 2, 800 is this one, density of oil. So rho g, rho s g and h, this is 0.2. so because of height is 20, right? From here to here it is 20 height, that's why 0.2. so this is rho g h, this is rho 1 g h1. So pb minus 2943 minus 1569 we'll get. So from that we'll get pb equals to pb minus 4512.6. this is second equation. By equating these two, so PA minus 2943 equals to PB minus 45126. So PB minus PA equals to 4515.6 minus 2943. So finally we'll get the difference as 1569.6. This is the difference required according to the question. Third question, water is flowing through two different pipes too, which an inverted differential manometer having an oil of specific gravity 0.8 is connected. The pressure head in the pipe A is 2 meters of water. Find the pressure in the pipe B for the manometer readings as shown in the figure. So we need to find out the pressure in the pipe B. Let's see, pressure head is nothing but A, that we can take it as P by rho G. So that is given as 2 meters of water. So PA equals to this rho G will come this side to the right side. So rho G into 2, that is nothing but rho is nothing but 1000 because of density of water. So 1000 into 9.81 into 2. So that is 19,620 Newton per meter square. Figure shows the arrangement taking XX as datum line and pressure below XX in the left limb is PA minus rho 1 G H1. So PA already we know that is 19,620, substitute here. Rho 1 G H1 is 1009.81.3. By substituting these values we will get 16,677 Newton per meter square. So pressure below XX in the right limb, so that is PB minus this rho 1 G H1 minus this oils, so rho G H. So because of this height is 12, that's why we'll take 0.12. So 800 is nothing but 0.2, 0.8 is the oil, so specific gravity into 1000 is its density. So PB minus 981 minus 941.76. So PB minus 1922.76. So after getting this, equating the two pressures, we'll get PB minus 1922.76 equals to 16677. So by equating these two, we'll get PB equals to 18,599 Newton per meter square. So that we can convert into Newton per centimeter square. So PB equals to 1.85 Newton per centimeter square. This is what the way of getting answer. So thing is that first of all we need to find out the pressure in the left side. So that is nothing but rho g1 h1. So after that we need to find out in the right limb. After getting first left limb by right limb, we need to equate left and right, then we'll get the required answer. Next question, a pipe contains an oil of specific gravity 0.9. a differential manometer connected at the two points A and B shows a difference in mercury level as 15 centimeters. Find the difference by pressure at the two points. So oil specific gravity is 0.9, so 0.9 into 1000 it will become 900 kg per meter cube. So the specific gravity becomes density equals to 900 kg per meter cube. So difference in mercury level is H given as 15 centimeters, that we can take it in meters as 0.15 meters. So specific gravity of mercury is 13.6, that is standard, into 1000 to convert into density. The difference of pressure is given by equation PA minus PB equals to G into H into rho G minus P1. So G is 9.81 we know, H is 0.15 given in the question. So rho G is 13,600, so mercury density, and rho 1 is density of oil, so that is 900. By substituting all these values we'll get PA minus PB equals to 18,688 Newton per meter square. This is what the way of finding out the differences of the pressures. Next question, a single column manometer is connected to a pipe containing a liquid of specific gravity 0.9 as shown in figure. Find the pressure in the pipe if the area of the reservoir is 100 times the area of the tube for the manometer reading shown in figure. The specific gravity of mercury is 13.6, that is standard one. So after this figure, this height is 40, this is 20 centimeter. Specific gravity of oil given as 0.9, multiplying with 1000 we'll get its density 900 kg per meter cube. So specific gravity of heavy liquid is 13.6 into 1000 is density of its mercury. So area of reservoir by area of right limb is 100, A by A is given as 100. So height of liquid is H1, that is 20 centimeter. So this is 20 centimeter. We can take it in meters as 0.2 meters. Rise of mercury in the right limb is H2, that is 40 centimeters this side, so that is 0.4 meters. So PA is pressure in pipe. So using equation we get PA equals to A by A into H2 rho 2g minus rho 1g plus H2 rho 2 means rho 2g H2 minus rho 1g H1. So this is a very important equation in manometers. Substituting the values like A by A given as 100. So small a by capital A is reverse of that, that is 1/100. So H2 is 40 centimeters, that is 0.4. Rho 2 is nothing but mercury, that is 13.6 into 1000. So G is 9.81 minus rho 1 G is 900 into 9.81. So next to H2, rho 2 G is 0.4, 13.6, 1000 and 9.81. Next H1, rho 1 G is 0.2, 900, 9.81. So by substituting all these values, we'll get Pi equals to 5.21 Newton per centimeter square. This is our required answer. Thank you for watching this video. Do subscribe and share my videos. This is your Mahesh Dole.